Few, if any, have more experience filleting and cooking kokanee than Mike Hall, who's been catching Flaming Gorge kokanee like these for a lot of years. I asked Mike to show us how he fillets and cooks his fish, but first I introduced him to his first honer sharpener.
I can actually feel that, take the little burrs off and sharpen that edge. That little bit of flex in the honer, that's pretty neat. Sure a lot easier than using a stone too. Slicing here. I like to take the ribs right off of mine. Just take their whole fillet and lay it right over. That is one nice sharp knife. You can't do that unless that knife's razor sharp, you know that? Peach pepper. Skin right off, then we'll take them little Y bones right out of there. The Y bones curve towards the top of the fillet. Well, that's nice to have that sharp knife. There disposes a completely boneless fillet. Is like dinner. First trick is to get your fillets nice and dry. You don't want any water on them at all. All they'll do is splatter in the oil. They'll cook a lot better this way. You want to take the fillet, and it has two sides. One side is where the skin was, is kind of gray on one side. The other side is completely orange. You want to lay this orange side up into the pan. Be careful of the hot oil. Don't make sure that your oil is not too hot. You can overcook fish just like anything else. So lay your fillets in the pan just like so. I've got a little fish seasoning salt. I'm going to take and sprinkle that over them. That's probably plenty. And I'm not going to turn the fillets. That's the other trick. Don't turn the fillets over. Let them cook just like that. Make sure it's the skin side down. We'll let them cook until we can run a fork through it. Your fork, it'll feel rubbery when you touch it if it's not cooked. When you poke that with a fork, the fork will slide right through it when it's cooked. Okay, and I will put a cover over the pan that holds any splatters down as well as it allows the fish to evenly heat from both sides. You just have to watch them real, real close because they'll cook within a couple of 3 minutes. It's not a long-term thing. Just make sure you got your fork so you can test, make sure they're done. Once they're done, pull them out of there. Okay, as they begin to cook, you'll notice that they turn from orange to kind of a flesh color. When that whitish flesh color gets all the way through it, then test them with your fork. The fork should just poke through and slip right out. If it's not cooked, it'll be feel rubbery or it won't go through. So the center is not quite done on this fillet, and the edges are cooked. A nice fleshy color. I'll test them with the fork. Fork goes in, comes out real easy. That's perfect. Take the lid off and we'll turn the heat off. Dish them up. Nice boneless fillet for dinner.